Hi everyone, my name is Iveta. In today's video, we will cover the topic of IP blocking in terms of web scraping and answer some commonly asked questions. We will discuss how IP address blocking works, the main reasons of IP blocking, and how to avoid getting blocked while collecting public data. Let's start. So, what is IP blocking exactly? IP address blocking, also known as an IP ban, is a website security measure that blocks requests from the certain IP addresses. Most of the time, IP blocking is used to prevent cyber attacks and other malicious activity, but it can also block good bots from performing automated public data collection and accessing geo-restricted content. Geo-blocking is a type of IP ban that restricts access to online content based on the geographical location of a user. But what are the actions that usually lead to a blocked IP address? Let's go over the most common reasons. First, sending too many frequent requests. The target you're aiming for may have a limited number of actions that can be done on the website at a certain time. Exceeding this number most probably will lead to blocks. Second, missing cookies. It might look suspicious if you don't send any cookies. Another reason is miscorrelation between different request attributes. For example, the time zone should match the IP address location. Also, a suspicious browser configuration such as disabled JavaScript. Since different browsers handle JavaScript differently, the web can check you. Finally, non-human behavior. If you put enough effort into simulating mouse and keyboard actions, it should be fine. But if you only use JavaScript to interact with the page and click things on it, the website will recognize you as a bot. How do you actually know whether you've been blocked or not? Well, it's simple. Once you have marked as suspicious, the website will start tracking using your IP address. If you get blocked, the website will punish you by limiting your actions or access. For example, it will show you a 404 page, give you captchas to solve, or offer you fake data. If you've been unfortunate enough and gotten your IP address blocked, try using these tips to unblock it. First, you should stop sending requests from the blocked IP for a few hours or days. Second, try to re-evaluate your scraping and fingerprinting tactics. Later, I'll explain how to do it. Then, after you get your scraping patterns fixed, try sending requests again using a different approach. All in all, it's always a good idea to avoid getting blocked rather than trying to unblock your IP once it's already happened. Follow these simple steps to web scrape without getting blocked. First, check the robot's exclusion rules. Before crawling or scraping any website, make sure your targets allow data gathering from their page. Inspect the robot's exclusion rules, robots.txt file, and respect the rules of the website. Also, control the scraping speed. To mitigate the risk of being blocked, you should consider how you distribute the requests over time. For instance, you can add random breaks between requests or initiate wait commands before performing a specific action. Another thing you should do is to use proxy servers. Web crawling would hardly be possible without proxies. Pick a reliable proxy service provider and choose between the Datacenter and residential IP proxies depending on your task. Finally, rotate IP addresses. When you're using a proxy pool, it's essential that you rotate your IP addresses. If you send too many requests from the same IP address, the target website will soon identify you as a threat and block your IP address. Proxy rotation makes you look like a number of different internet users and reduces your chances of getting blocked. Now let's quickly wrap everything up. IP address blocking is a security measure employed by websites to protect themselves from potential malicious activities. It can also be used to restrict access to geo-based content. However, IP blocking can become a problem while web scraping publicly available data. In order to avoid IP bans, we suggest that you check robots exclusion protocol before scraping, reduce the scraping speed, avoid image scraping, use proxy servers, and rotate your IP. That's all you need to know about IP blocking and how to avoid it while scraping. If you need more information about this or any other topic, check our website and blog posts. In case of questions, feel free to contact us at hello@oxylabs.io. If you enjoyed the video, share it and subscribe it to our channel for more content. See you in other videos.